ain't first, you're last. You know what I'm talking about? That freak.
Bad fights can't go for that, no, no can do. Bad fights can't go for that, can't go for that, can't go for that, no can do.
Hey, yo, 1 to the 2 to the 3 to the 4, good fight in store to settle the score. The best 140 pounders on the planet, that's Jose Ramirez and Josh Taylor, god damn it. Ramirez won his first belt in some scrapping action, unified being hooker in head snapping fashion. Taylor I thought was hype based off my theories, won his belts in World Boxing Super Series, winner rules the division that they call home. Be pound for pound, top five like my boy Rome. English fighters have been failing greatly in the ring, bodied by Mexicans lately. Trying to comprehend how this will end, I try not to bend from that notable trend. But man, what if that curse happens to me legit? Then British boxing will be in some serious shit.
Bad fights can't go for that, no, no can do. Bad fights can't go for that, can't go for that, can't go for that, no can do. Bad fights can't go for that, no, no can do. Bad fights can't go for that, can't go for that, can't go for that, no can do.
Ramirez, being underdog, has a burden, motivation will be stirred and very determined. He brings pressure and pressure bust pipes. Taylor's not one of those quick adjust types. Same height but longer reach, advantage for Ramirez, something that Taylor has to manage. Don't mean that he can't cause any damage. In this fight, Ramirez just can't take him light.
That's right.
Taylor's whole foundation seems to be a sink, a deceptive punch that you'd miss if you blink. Educated fork is very snaky, paired with a chin that's barely shaky. A chess match that will go down to the wire. Big Pat ain't no liar, this shit will be fire. 12 rounds of hell to the final bell. Taylor unifies the division by unanimous decision.
Bad fights can't go for that, no, no can do. Bad fights can't go for that, can't go for that, can't go for that, no can do. Bad fights can't go for that, no, no can do. Bad fights can't go for that, can't go for that, can't go for that, no can do.
Yeah, bad fights you can't go for that. And do you know why I say bad fights you can't go for that? Because when they're announced, you groan, you complain, you're like, oh, this is some bullshit. And rightfully so. And for some reason, this particular fight is getting that treatment. You have two undefeated fighters, each of them unified two of the 140 titles. And for some reason, you can't get no marketing, no promotion, no commercials, nothing towards this particular fight. They dropped the ball on this fight in every sense of the word. Like, even tickets announced. Like, they said that, you know, fans can actually be there. I haven't seen one email from Top Rank saying that, you know, that, you know, when the tickets are and when they're even available. And then all of a sudden, they're not there anymore, yo. So, yeah, they really dropped the ball on this fight, and it's disgusting. And on top of that, you know, you have the news with Fury and Wilder 3 in there. That's like dominating boxing news. You know, it's just awful, man. So, yeah, Saturday night, man, tune in, man. Like, this is not a bad fight. This is a good fight. Now, if it turned out to be a bad fight, well, it's my bad. I might have jinxed it. But, yeah, I promise you, man, you're going to see something special. Big Pat, baby. Ring, gang, radio.
No, I can't go for that, huh? And ring gang can't go for that, what? And boxing can't go for that, yeah. And the fans can't go for that, no.